component. Right? All right. So Lightning Experience is made of Lightning Experience UI is made of Lightning Pages. Everything that you see is a Lightning page inside Lightning Experience. Right? And these Lightning Pages are in turn made out of components, what we call experience components. Components which provide a particular kind of an experience. So everything that you see on that page is a component, right? Which is embedded in a Lightning page. Like for example, the header that you see on the screenshot there, the path component, the tabs, activity chatter details. That's a tab set component. And then below that we have a chatter publisher component. And then we have an activity timeline component. Then we have a news component, and everything is an experience component in itself, right? So components are building blocks of the Lightning UI, and there are two kinds of components. Just for clarity here, experience component is the component that you actually use to put inside a Lightning page. And then base components or base Lightning components are the smaller building blocks of code that you use to build these experience components. To put an experience component together, you use base components. Right? Base components are code. Experience components is something that you can probably use in the Lightning app builder to drag and drop components. So you have an experience component, you can drag and drop it into a Lightning page, which will then be available in Lightning Experience UI. Right. Okay, so this is about where we use components and what is a component for, right? What's the purpose, right? So how do we actually build these components, right? Let's have, can I get a raise of hands of people who have built a Lightning component right now? Did anybody build a Lightning component? Just three of you, okay, all right. Okay, let's look at the aspects of creating a Lightning component and building a component which actually does something, right? So when you create a component, you get what we call a component bundle. So this is a component bundle, right? So when you create a component, for example, in the developer console, you get this bundle of various sections of the component. Right, each having its own purpose. This is a way of separating separation of concerns inside a component. What various pieces do? Okay, the first section is the component UI markup itself. That is where the markup goes in. It actually gives UI to this component. Right, and then we have the JavaScript controller, which is what gives the logic. To a Lightning component. Lightning components are client-side, as in they render inside a browser, right? And the controller is JavaScript, because JavaScript is a client-side programming language, right? So Lightning components controller is a JavaScript controller, and it holds all the logic for this component, right? And then we have the helper section. Helper is, again, JavaScript. But it's just a way of organizing your code into a reusable block. So you just put a function in a helper and just use it in different sections of the component instead of actually writing that code multiple times. Right? It's like a reusable section of the component. And then we have styling, all the CSS, all the prettiness that the component, is going to have that goes into the style section using CSS. And then we have the documentation section where you can actually put some documentation about how to use this component, what this component is for and stuff. This is basically for external people who are using your component, right? And then we have the renderer, which is to modify the custom rendering behavior of a component. Let's not go too deep into that today. And then we have a design section and an SVG section, right? So design section is to make the component configurable. Inside the app builder. We'll not go too deep into that as well. And then the SVG is where you create an icon for this component. Right? SVG is a simple meta graphics, which is used for things like creating icons and stuff. So if you want to give a custom icon to this component, just in case you want to, so you can do that using SVG. Right? So that's Lightning bundling for you. Yeah, you have a question?
Yeah, Mm-hmm. So if you put a function in there, can it be accessed by other components as well?
It can be accessed by the controller and the renderer as well, because they are both JavaScript.
Okay, but what about like a completely different component that you're reading?
No. Just. So each component is self-contained. It exists irrespective of the existence of any other component. Like, we are independent. Okay. Inside this, we're not going to talk about the whole bundle here because we're just getting started. We're going to talk about the UI. We're going to talk about the controller, the helper, and we're going to talk about events as well after that. Okay, building UI, anybody who's familiar with Visual Force or HTML know that you need markup to create UI, right? And Lightning component markup also has a framework, it's built on a framework called Aura, which has its own Aura tags, like you have Apex colon tags inside Visual Force. Right, and then we also have something called base components. So this is the building blocks that I was talking about previously. Right, so base Lightning components are pre-built by Salesforce and provided to developers to use in their code to build custom components. Right, so they have inbuilt functionality, and they also have inbuilt Lightning design system styling, and they have accessibility and general HTML standards already built in, right? So you can directly use them. For example, you want an icon. You want to show an icon, right? And the Lightning design system has a bunch of icons that you can use from. But so you have to upload the icon, call it as a static resource and stuff like that. Instead, you can just say Lightning icon and give it a name. So that icon is automatically rendered inside. Right, so these are shortcut components which with inbuilt functionality, similar to what we had in Visual Force, with the Visual Force components and stuff. So we have basically three kinds of base components, input control like buttons and tabs, right? And then we have visual components which are UI elements. For example, you want a card kind of an interface, right? Just card is a way of showing details, right? And then you want to show an icon, or you want to use something like the grid system that you generally have in CSS frameworks like Bootstrap and stuff, which makes your page responsive based on the device that it's being accessed from, right? So you can use Lightning layout for that. So yeah, these are shortcut components to use functionality that is already inbuilt into them. That's UI, that's the markup. And then we have the client-side logic, which is through the JavaScript controller that I showed you in the bundle, right? So any actions or any interactions can trigger JavaScript functions inside Lightning components. For example, if you look at that simple example, so we just want to say if I click on that button, so we have a Lightning button right there, called click me. If I click on that, something should happen, right? So you can just say, if I click on that, run this function. And you can put that function inside our JavaScript controller. There's a particular syntax of doing that. That's what you see here. Put the function name, then pass the component and the event as the parameters, then do whatever you want inside the function. For example, we are changing the value of the text attribute here, which is actually changing what it's actually displaying, right? As simple as that. Okay, so this is about logic, but what if you want to work with data inside components, right? So you built all kinds of interactive JavaScript behavior. But how do you work with data? So since Lightning is a client-side framework, right? You need to access the server to get data. So how do you do that? You do that by calling an Apex controller that you have created, right? So you can create an Apex controller. You can create an Apex controller which can actually be called by an external JavaScript controller inside Lightning component. The Apex controller can have the data retrieval and data manipulation, whatever you want. inside it. So you can just call it, run it, and get the result and use it inside your component, right? So for that reason, we have our markup and then the controller. And the controller has a connection to the Apex controller, right? And the Apex controller does whatever it does usually as well. So it accesses data through SOCL or DML and gives the controller, a client-side controller, a response that it can work with. All right, so we spoke about building the UI using functions. Yes, question?
You can't access the Apex controller directly from the markup?
No. So the markup can only only mention what function needs to run.
What JavaScript
needs to run. You can't put actual logic inside the markup. OK, we spoke about UI. Yeah, question? Sorry, can you be a little louder?
Mm-hmm.
So right, the question is, what's the equivalent for Apex testing for these JavaScript controllers, right? So right now, there is no such testing equivalent. There is a linting tool that's available that can actually test your code and stuff. But there is going to be soon there is going to be a new testing framework that's coming out for Lightning. So right now, there is no unit testing framework as of now. All right, we spoke about the UI. We spoke about adding logic to your custom logic or interactivity to your component. Then we spoke about working with data, right? And then let's also talk about events inside components, right? Now, there are three different kinds of events generally in the Lightning component framework. First is the system events. These are already events that that happen as part of the functionality of the framework itself, the framework lifecycle, which you can actually handle on yourself. So for example, things like a first time a component is initiated on the screen, or when something, just when one of the attributes of the component is changed, so things like that. So these kind of events are automatically fired by the framework, and we can actually handle these events inside our components. So for example, we want to say when the component is initiated, get me a list of records from Salesforce or something, right? Or when there is a change in the attribute of a component, like in one of the values of the component's variables, when the value changes, I want to do something, right? So these kind of things can be handled by using the system events, and we're going to see all this in our demo code shortly. Don't worry about that, right? So those are system events. And then we have the events which are automatically available inside the Salesforce One and Lightning Experience UI. So that's called the 1.app container, because that's what the Salesforce One and Lightning Experience use. So there are some inbuilt events that are available inside the 1.app container, which is relevant to Salesforce and the Force.com platform, that you can directly use or directly trigger. For example, if you want to show something like a success message or informative message as a pop-up, which disappears in a few minutes, right? So that's called a toast inside the Lightning Design System. And there is a way of doing that without actually building all that functionality. All you need to do is just call that event and just fire it, right? So you can just say in your JavaScript code, fire the force show toast event. When it happens, you get a informational message on your screen. Or things like, if I click on a button, or if I click on a record's name or ID, I want to be navigated to that record's home. So that is also possible in custom code, but you don't actually have to write all that, because there's an event available for that you can directly use called the force navigate to S object. So you can just say navigate S object and set up a parameter as the ID of that record. When you click on that, you go to that record. Right? So these are again shortcut events that are inbuilt that you can directly use inside your components. For example, refresh you when somebody when something happens, you want to refresh the whole component once or refresh the page or something. So those kind of events are available already. You don't need to create them yourselves, right? Reduces the amount of code that you need to write. And then we have custom events, right? So these are inbuilt events, but what if you want some custom communication between components? Let's say you have like 3 to 4 components on the page, and when something happens on one component, you probably want to pass some information to another component. So how do you do that? So we do that by using events, custom events. And there are two kinds of custom events. It's either a component event or an application event, right? So eventing in Lightning Components is like a publish, subscribe kind of functionality. So one component, if we create an event and set some parameters to that event, and one component can fire that event with a particular information, and another component can actually handle that or subscribe to that and handle that occurrence of that event and get the information from the other component, right? So this is a way of communication between components. And there are two kinds of components of events. One is the component event, which can be fired and handled by either the same component or a component that is actually containing that component. So you can basically have components inside components as well, right? So the external component or the component itself can handle these kinds of events, right? And there's also application events. For example, there is a Lightning page in which there are like 5 different components, and component one wants to firing an event, right? And it's probably sending some parameters as well. And component three wants to do something about it, right? So if something happens with component one, component three needs to know. So this is done through application events, right? So this is a communication happens inside between Lightning components. Any questions? Yes.
Are these any related to the new custom events you can define in platform events?
Oh, the platform events is a different thing. Platform events is an API level, force.com platform level feature. This is specifically for Lightning components, the UI. There is a way of listening to those events, but it's not straightforward. I mean, there is a way of doing it. All right, so that's events. So you know how to create these components. So where do we create these components? Right? How can we create components? Where do we write this code? The different developer tools based on your own style. We have our good old developer console, and we also have our Eclipse-based force.com IDE, and you also have extension for Sublime Text as well, specifically for Lightning components, right? All right. With that, let's just have a look at a demo pretty much an implementation of what we spoke until now. Let's go into the demo. Okay, so I'm on my Lightning Experience homepage inside the sales app, and I have created a tab here called Contact List, which is just a Lightning component tab. I created a Lightning component, and I am displaying it as a tab, right? So I go to Contact List. So a few things happen here. When I load this page, we have a pop which says, success, your contacts are loaded. So that's a toast. So that's already happening. So let me just refresh it once again. And the component initiates, and the data is loaded, the list of contacts are loaded, you have a success message on the top. And we have a contacts header section here, and then the number of contacts that we are actually displaying. And we have a pop drop-down to choose the lead source that we want to filter the list of contacts on. Right now, you're seeing all the contacts. And if I choose a different lead source, the list automatically changes. Right, let me change it to referral. So these are the only two contacts with the referral lead source. And if you look at the contacts, it's displayed in a particular UI style. That's called the card element inside Lightning Design System. So we are showing the contact name and the phone and address and email in a card, in a Lightning card. And we also have a details button. And when I click on that, I actually go to the full contact record homepage, right? So if I click on it, I go to the contact with all the details. And this is just a smaller view, right? So this is one component which has another component inside it. And we'll see how this is built. This is a breakup of how it was built. One, there is a toast message which appears when the list of records are loaded. And then there is a header section which has the heading and the subheading and the number of contacts that it's actually loaded. And then we have a lead source dropdown that you can choose from. And when you select something, the list of contacts that are displayed is changed, right? And you also, each of the contacts have a detail button. And when you click on it, you need to go to the contact record. All right, let's dig into the core. Okay, so this is my contact list component. On the right side, you can see the whole bundle there. So we have our component and controller has a JavaScript code, and our helper also has JavaScript. So we are using a helper in our component. Okay, let me just take that thing off. Okay, so I've minimized code a little to show the structure, and then we'll dig deeper into the lines inside that sections, right? So the first line is, in the first line we are actually handling a particular system event. So if you remember, I told you there's this system events that automatically happen, things like component initialization, change in value of an attribute and stuff like that. It can actually be handled by a component, right? So right here we are handling an inbuilt event called init. So this event is basically the initialization of this component when the component loads for the first time, right? So we're saying when this happens, run a particular JavaScript function, right? So I'm saying on initiation, run do init, which is my custom JavaScript function, my JavaScript controller, right? Let's see how what that controller is doing. So I go to the contact list controller. So this is doInit. So all it does is call a particular function inside my helper. So I can write the helper function right here inside this control itself, or I can put it in the helper for better reusability of code. So I've used my helper for this. In the helper, I have a load contacts function. So this is the load contacts function, and you're actually, what this is doing is it is initiating a method inside an Apex controller called getContacts, and it's actually running that method and getting the response, right? Let's go to the Apex controller that has this function. So the way you wire up an Apex controller to a component is by just writing the component controller name on the top. So this Lightning component is using an Apex controller called contact controller, right? So let's if we look at the contact controller Apex class, so it's basically returning a list of contacts. That's all it's doing. All the contacts that are inside this org with these particular fields, right? Name, ID, name, mailing list, phone, email, and lead source. It runs a SQL query and returns the list of contacts, right? So when the contact list is returned, the callback function is run. So this is a particular syntax that you need to use to call Apex. So I've minimized the callback function. Let me just expand that for you so that we'll see what's happening here. So what it's doing is we are actually checking if it's a successful response from the Apex controller to the JavaScript controller. If it's a success, we are setting up the returned value into these two attributes inside our component. So if you look at the contact list again, there are a few attributes that we have created for this component. Attributes are pretty much like variables that can be used inside this component, right? So we have a contacts attribute, which is a list of contacts. And we have a contact list attribute. And we also have a total contacts attribute, which is just a number. It's an integer type attribute. The other two are a list of contact kind type of an attribute, right? So it's setting both these values to the return value. We are using two attributes because we have some logic that we need to implement to filter that list of contacts. So don't worry about that. So using this, we have called Apex and got the list of contacts that we wanted to work with. And then, so once that is done, we just want to show the number of contacts that have been returned or that have been displayed. Right? So that is being done in a function called updateTotal, which is another function that we have inside. So that is the function which counts the number of contacts that are being displayed here and shows them by saving them on the update totals attribute that we have, that we create, the total contacts attribute that we have here, right? So this, so we have a list of contacts that we can work with, and we also have a total of contacts that we can work with. Let's now display them on this component now that they are returned. Okay, so in our component, we have a header section and a body section. The header has a little icon and a title and a subtitle, and then the number of contacts. Okay, let me expand this. So we are using base Lightning components and the Lightning layout component, which is similar to CSS grid system. And inside the Lightning layout, we have a couple of layout items. The first item is just an icon called standard contact. This is one of the icons that is available in the Lightning design system. So that this is the icon that you see there, the icon over here. And then another layout item, which is a heading and a subheading, right? Contacts and contact viewer. So that's also displayed here. So with very, very minimal CSS, by just using the base Lightning components, we are getting this functionality automatically, right? And then that's the Lightning layout for the header. And we are also displaying the number of contacts that we found, right? So that is another line of the Lightning layout. This is another section, right? Inside the layout item, we have an attribute called total contacts that we are displaying. So it just shows the value of that attribute inside your component. Okay, so that is the header. And then below that, we have the body section, which is this particular dropdown and all the list of contacts below that. Right, in our body, we have, and again, we are using Lightning layout. One of the layout items is a dropdown menu option, for which we are using Lightning Select. This is another base Lightning component to show a list of drop-down options, right? Okay, so these are the list of options that we are showing. We're showing a placeholder, select a lead source, and then a referral, social media, which are two lead sources that we can filter on in our dropdown, and then the all option, which shows all the contacts. Right, and then we created our lead source, and now comes the list of contacts that we are displaying. Right, just like we have loops inside programming languages, like for loops and stuff, we have something called an Aura iteration, which is similar to an Apex repeat inside Visual Force. Right, and in this iteration, we are actually displaying another Lightning component that we have created called contacts. right? So based on number of contacts, this component is repeated those many number of times by and shows the component. All right, let's have a look at this contacts component as well. So this is our contacts component, and this is the markup for that. Again, it's using the Lightning card based component to display the contact details. All right, let me just expand that. Okay, so inside a Lightning card, we have a details button, which is again a Lightning button, and it has a function wired to it that runs when you click on that button. Right, and then you have the email address, the phone, the mailing list, and the name of the contact and stuff that are displayed in a Lightning card format. And so when you click on that button, you're supposed to go to the detail of that page. Right, so if you look at the controller, so that's what's happening here. So like I told you, there are these inbuilt events available in Salesforce One and Lightning Experience that you can actually fire to get some basic functionality that's already built in, right? So in this function, we're using the event called force navigate to S object, and this is how you can use it. Just initiate the event and set up the parameter as the record ID that you want to navigate to, and just fire it, right? Initiate navigate S object, set up the ID, and then fire. So that's what happens when you actually click on this details record. So it actually takes you to that page directly. So you haven't written much code to do that because it's already inbuilt. So that is our contacts component. And then, what is our init handler doing after we get a list of contacts, right? So we did the update total, that is definitely there. And you also might have noticed that when you actually initiate this component for the first time, there's an event that happens here, which shows a toast message. Says success, your contacts have been loaded. So how are we doing that? There is a hard way of doing that, and there is also an easy way of doing that by using the inbuilt event called force show toast. So that's what we did here. So we have initiated the force show toast event, and if it's successful, set up the parameters, which is actually what needs to be displayed on that page, and just fire it. So that's all that's being displayed on the Lightning component. So we had a look at the toast and the header and the lead source, and then the list of contacts. So when you change it, the list automatically changes. Any questions on the demo or the code inside? Yes. Toast is just a name for that UI element. Shows up as a toast. It pops up. Yeah. $A is a utility function that includes a lot of system classes that you can use, system methods. For example, if you look at this $A.NQAction. So NQAction is a JavaScript function that is provided for the developer to use. What it does is it sends the request from the client-side controller to the server-side controller. So that it specifically does that, and $A is the utility class that holds all these functions. It's basically utility functions. So Aura is a JavaScript framework. So we have JavaScript frameworks like Angular, React, and stuff, right? So those are all frameworks that can be used to build JavaScript-based applications quicker than just plain JavaScript. Aura is also a framework like that. And Salesforce used Aura to build Lightning. So you can also extend Lightning by using the internal Aura framework. So that's why it keeps saying Aura, because it's built on Aura. So it's a framework like Angular and React that has been built by Salesforce itself. It has nothing to do with Visual Force. Yes. You don't really need that. I just took it to build some logic to do the filtering. So that's just some internal filtering that I'm doing. Like of the card, this one. Yeah. So there is a specific way of using a Lightning card. Lightning card is a UI pattern that is part of the Lightning design system itself. So if you look at the design system website, so card is a UI element. This is what it looks like. And it's kind of declarative. You can say this has to be something, this has to be something or stuff. But you can't say this should be on the right side, something like that. And there are a few variants available, base and with tiles. I want to show it in different states. There are a few variants of it available. But it's kind of declarative. It's already built. You just give it, configure it, and show it. Any other questions? Yes. Based on the return list of contacts, so what I'm doing is internally inside the JavaScript itself, it's, instead of calling Apex again, internally in the list itself, I've created another array which holds a list of contacts which are from this lead source or something like that. I'm showing that. Yeah, it's there inside. Yeah, this is the function for that. So these are the two attributes that we have set from the return value. And I've created a couple of variables inside JavaScript to hold them. And I'm using another array called filter, which runs a for loop and says, it creates basically an array which holds the list of contacts which belong to the particular lead source that I've selected. So it does that and just shows that value. All right, so this is just a beginning, just a quick getting started talk. If you want to go further, first place you want to go to is Trailhead. They are pretty good modules and projects. There are a few new ones as well with this release on Lightning development. And then, of course, there's our documentation, the whole developer guide. And also, there are lots of blogs being written on using these Lightning components and stuff like that. Official blogs from Salesforce developer blogs as well as a lot of our community folks who are contributing with that knowledge. With that, if you don't have any more questions, thank you so much. Yeah, we'll take it offline.